So let's take a look at how the idea of primary versus secondary sources applies to your research in art history. Let's say you wanted to do research on a weirdly fascinating exhibition that the Nazis staged in 1937 of what they called degenerate art, in German, entartete Kunst. And it was basically an exhibition they put together to vilify a whole group of avant-garde artists and their art. So what would the primary sources be? Well, it might include things like initial newspaper articles, right? But because this is an art exhibition, we also have things like archival photographs, such as these that show Hitler and his henchman Goebbels attending the exhibition. We have other primary sources too, though, that you could consider using, such as the exhibition catalog that was written by a Nazi author explaining their rationale for the show. But the fact of the matter is most of your research as an art history student is going to be based in secondary sources typically. So, secondary sources would include journal articles, encyclopedia entries, and books. So, for example, there have been quite a few books that have come out on topics that include this exhibition that you could consider using amongst your secondary sources for your research. And the key feature of these books is that they're written from the perspective of years of reflection on the topic, so they give you the larger art historical context that emerged over time. The question is, though, how do these concepts of primary and secondary sources apply to studying earlier art, such as the Byzantine period, for example? If you were looking at the 6th century Church of Holy Wisdom built in modern-day Istanbul, back then called Constantinople, and you might initially assume that you're kind of out of luck when it comes to primary sources. But it turns out that we actually do have texts that survive from the 6th century that give us the first-hand perspective of the people who first saw the church. This is a manuscript page from an author named Procopius, who lived and worked as a writer for the court of Justinian. Just as is the case for a lot of medieval manuscripts, we're lucky enough to have English translations available online. So these kind of primary sources can really augment your research on a topic by bringing this first-hand perspective to your work. But as is the case of looking at the art exhibition we talked about a few minutes ago, most of your research is going to be grounded in secondary sources. That would include all of those specialized journal articles, but even books too. There are quite a few books written on this specific building because of its importance in medieval architecture and just architecture of the world. And so more continue to come out all the time. Like this one just came out in May 2019, incorporating the most recent archaeological find. So this also points to the fact that even though the subject's really old, you still want to find the most recent scholarship because scholarly thoughts on a topic are always evolving. Another good place to begin when you're doing your work in secondary sources is looking at reference works like Oxford Art Online, right? Because they give you that big picture view, but it's written by an authoritative source. So that can give you a nice frame of reference for understanding the more specialized secondary sources that you'll then investigate and use to ground your paper.
Tom always seems to use the library efficiently, effectively. watch.
Another way you can also explore the difference between primary and secondary sources is poking around places like the subject guides on the library website. This one for medieval history gives you a better feeling for, you know, primary versus secondary sources, where you might find them, and they're all brought together really easily and conveniently in this one place. So knowing now more about the difference between primary and secondary sources, I hope you'll be able to make strategic choices as you do your research as an art history student and find a good balance that best answers the research questions you're trying to answer. Thank you.